part 4 from the video series about tape recorder circuits. This is the pre-amplifier circuit that's very usable to make a tape head pre-amplifier. It was originally from Philips, and you see, for instance, a few tape heads, erase head, also an erase head, and a record, two record heads. I think this is stereo and this is mono, but whatever. You can see that the gap between the magnetic poles from the tape head, sorry, from the erase head is big, and the magnetic gap, the gap between the poles from the record head is not visible. It's tiny. And that has all to do with the frequency, with how tinier the distance between these two poles is, the better the record head can be used for higher frequencies. So that's important, and that's a whole science, and this video is too short for that. But anyway, this is a good preamplifier that I've used in the past. Works very good. You can see the decoupling unit now here on the upper side of the screen. And the playback head, that's also used as a record head, has a DC resistance from approximately 500 ohms. And it needs an extreme amplification, because the voltages that are generated when the tape flows alongside the playback head are tiny. Very, very tiny, perhaps 50 microvolts or so. I don't know that exactly, but anyway, that's the reason why we use here a two-stage amplifier with an extreme amplification. So this is the best circuit to do that. And this I have already showed in an earlier video. Here you see how I reconstructed a Philips cassette deck from 1962. I've used the original print circuit and made it, constructed it in another enclosure, and it still works fine. So that was more or less all to tell. So pen over somewhat the record head and playback head. The first transistor, you can use a transistor with a low noise figure, etc.